Can you mentally solve these simultaneous equations in 10 seconds? Did you say no? Come on, at least give it a try. Your time starts now. Your time is up. The correct answer is x equal to 6, y equal to 2. Let me first tell you the usual way of solving the simultaneous equations. But before I do that, let me give you a brief introduction of algebraic equations. All right? So anything that has an equal to sign is called an equation. Now, equation has different parts. The alphabets that you are seeing, x and y, they are known as variables. All right? This number that you are seeing here is known as a constant. And this 2 and 3 that you are seeing are known as coefficients. Basically, they are numbers that are put before the variables. All right? When there is no number put before a variable, the coefficient is always 1. But we don't write 1, all right? It is understood that it is 1. Now let's see the usual way of solving the simultaneous equations. Now there are a couple of ways for solving simultaneous equations, like elimination method, substitution method. I would be using elimination method to solve these equations the usual way. Basically, in elimination method, all we try to do is eliminate one variable out of the two variables, like x and y. So one variable would be eliminated. How? By making the coefficients equal. All right? So basically we cross multiply the coefficients. All right? So the coefficient of this x is 2. So I multiply this 2 here, and the coefficient of this x is 1. So I put 1 here. So let's put these equations here. So 2 times x is 2x, 2 times 2y is 4y, and 2 times 10 is 20. All right? And multiply this equation with 1. So it would be 2x plus 3y equal to 18. Now, to eliminate, you need to subtract. So change the sign. This is the standard procedure. All right? So 2x minus 2x will cancel out. So 0 will come here. 4y minus 3y is 1y. So I put y here. Now, 20 minus 18 is 2. So we have found out the value of y. Now put this value of y in any of these two equations to get the value of x. All right? So I put the value of y here. So I would get a new equation, x plus 2 times 2, isn't it? Because this y will become 2, so it will become 4 equal to 10. All right? Now subtract 4 from both the sides. So minus 4 here, minus 4 here. So this thing gets eliminated and you get x equal to 6. And that is what the answer is. X equal to 6, y equal to 2. As you have just seen, this usual way is indeed very long and it will require a lot of skill and talent to be able to do mentally with this method. You can give it a try. But wait, there is a better way of doing it. Now, to find the value of x, all you need to do is multiply this number with this number, like this, and then subtract from it the product of this number and this number. So 2 times 18 is 36, minus 3 times 10 is 30. All right? Now this is the numerator. Okay? Now let's find the denominator as well. Now to find the denominator, all you need to do is multiply this number again with this number, like this. So 2 times 2 is 4, and subtract from it the product of this number and this number. Since there is no number there, so it is 1. So 1 times 3 is 3, isn't it? So the answer is 36 minus 30 is 6, and 4 minus 3 is 1. 6 over 1 is nothing but 6. So x equal to 6. Now, once you have the value of one variable, finding the other variable is very easy. All right. So now substitute this value in any of these two equations. So you know that this x is 6, isn't it? Now 6 plus something equal to 10. So you know that 6 plus 4 equal to 10, and 2 times what equal to 4? So 2 times 2 equal to 4. So y equal to 2. That's what your answer is. You can do this mentally. Okay, so let's do it again, and this time mentally. So to find x, all you need to do is multiply this with this. So 2 times 18 is 36, and then subtract from it the product of this and this. 3 times 10 is 30. 36 minus 30 is 6, isn't it? Alright, now to find the denominator, all you need to do is multiply this with this. So 2 times 2 is 4, and 1 times 3 is 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. So x equal to 6, isn't it? Now to find y, just substitute the value of x in one of these two equations. So now you have this x as 6. So 6 plus something equal to 10, isn't it? So you know that 6 plus 4 equal to 10, and 2 times what equal to 4? 2 times 2 equal to 4. So y equal to 2. As simple as that. Okay, so now let's solve this using the crisscross technique of solving equations. Again, to find the value of x, all you need to do is multiply this 2 with 11, and then subtract the product of this 3 and 7, isn't it? So 2 11 times is 22, minus 3 7 times is 21. 22 minus 21 is 1, isn't it? This is the numerator. What would denominator be? 2 times 2 is 4, and 1 times 3 is 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. So x is 1 here. Now once you have the value of one variable, finding the other variable is very simple, isn't it? Now substitute this value of x in any of these two equations. So I'll prefer this equation, so I'll put 1 here. Alright, now you know that 1 plus something equal to 7. So you know that it is 6. 1 plus 6 equal to 7. So 2 times what equal to 6? 2 times 3 equal to 6. So y equal to 3. And there you have solved the equation. Now isn't that easy? In fact, algebra is the easiest branch of mathematics. So x equal to 9 times 11 is 99, and 2 times 47 is 94.
9.
And 99 minus 94 is 5. This is the numerator. To find the denominator, 9 times 1 is, and 4 times 2 is 8. And 9 minus 8 is 1. So x equal to 5. Now once you have this x, so put it in any of these two equations. This one would be much better. So put it here. Now this is 5. So 5 plus what equal to 11? You know that 5 plus 6 equal to 11. So 2 how many times is 6? 2 3 times is 6. So y equal to 3. That is your answer. X equal to 5, y equal to 3. How fast can you solve these simultaneous equations? And this time I'm not going to give you more than 5 seconds. Alright? So your time starts now. The time is up. The correct answer is x equal to 0 and y equal to 8 by 7. There it is. X equal to 0, y equal to 8 by 7. The usual way of solving these equations, it's way too time consuming. So I would not at all like to do it the usual way. So I'm just skipping this part. Let's see the faster way of doing it. You must have thought that the coefficients of these two simultaneous equations are much more difficult to multiply with, isn't it? So instead of giving you more time, I gave you just 5 seconds. Now you'll know why. Just look at the ratio of the coefficients of y in both the equations and compare it to the ratio of the constants. Do you see something special? Yes, their ratio is equal, isn't it? 7, 1 times is 7, 7, 2 times is 14. 8 1 times is 8, 8 2 times is 16. So this is also 1 by 2 and this is also 1 by 2. Whenever this happens, you can immediately put the value of other variable, to be equal to 0. Alright, so x equal to 0, as simple as that. So just quickly substitute this value in any of these two equations. So x equal to 0, so 6 times 0 is 0, so this thing becomes 0. Now what is left? 7y equal to 8, so y would be equal to 8 over 7, isn't it? You put the coefficient of y to the other side and it goes to the denominator, so y equal to 8 by 7. That is what your answer is. X equal to 0, y equal to 8 by 7. Tell me, wasn't that fast? Once again, let me repeat. When the ratio of the coefficients of y is equal to the ratio of the constants, then x equal to 0. And using the same logic, if the ratio of the coefficients of x equal to the ratio of the constant, then variable y would be equal to 0. Now, you try to solve these. So, the first thing that strikes you is that the ratio of coefficients of x is equal to the ratio of constants. So, immediately put y equal to 0. Now, once you have the value of one variable, finding the other variable is very easy, isn't it? So, if you put this value here, so this thing becomes 0, isn't it? So, 12x equal to 12. That means 12 times something equal to 12. So obviously 12 times 1 equal to 12. So x equal to 1. Now tell me, isn't that a good technique? At the first glance, if you see that multiplying with these coefficients is a big challenge, isn't it? They are intimidating numbers. But we didn't multiply them. That is the beauty of this technique. How fast can you find out that cube of which number would be this? In other words, you have to find the cube root of 32,768. I'm giving you 4 seconds for that. And believe me, even that is a luxury for your mind because it should not take you more than 2 seconds. Your time starts now. Your time is up. The correct answer is 32. There it is. Okay, so now let me show you this easy cal trick of finding the cube roots of numbers. Okay, so watch me. That is what my answer is. Was it too fast for you to follow? Alright, so let me explain. Then I assure you, you'll be calculating faster than this. Alright, because you'd be doing it mentally. I had to write it down for you to see, but you'll be doing it mentally. To find the cube root of any number whose answer lies anywhere between 1 to 100, all you need to do is see the last digit. If the last digit is 8, then put 2 here and strike out the last 3 digits. Alright, now see the number that is left. All you need to do now is find the number whose cube is nearest to this number. That is, either it is 32 or less than 32. Okay, so which would that number be? 3, isn't it? Because 3 cube is 27 and 27 is near to 32. 4 cube is 64, so it is more than that, so it is out of question. So all you need to do is find the number whose cube is either equal to this remaining number or less than that. Okay, so let me add here, if the last digit is 8, I told you to replace it with 2. Okay, if the last digit is 8, you replace it with 2. If it's 2, then you replace it with 8. Alright, if it's 7, then you replace it with 3 and vice versa. If it's 3, then replace it with 7. These two are known as conjugate pairs. Alright. All you need to do to find the conjugate pair of 8 is to subtract it from 10. Alright. So 10 minus 8 is 2. Alright. If you have to find the conjugate pair of 2, then you subtract from 10, 2. So again, you'll get 8. Same logic here. If you have to find the conjugate pair of 7, so 10 minus 7 is 3. And for 3, so 10 minus 3 is 7. Are you getting the point? Alright. For any other digit, if the last digit is any other digit other than 8273, that is these conjugate pairs, then copy it as it is. That means it's all the more simple. You don't even need to do all that. Okay? Like suppose if the last digit was 6 here, then you'll copy the 6 as it is here. If it was 5 here, you'll copy the 5 as it is. If it's 4 here, you'll copy the 4 as it is here. Are you getting the point? And for the next part, you know what you have to do. You have to find that which is the nearest cube to the remaining number. Alright? So, let's practice more examples of these. Okay, so now find out what would be the cube root of 79,507. Okay, so look at the last digit here. It is 7, and you know that 7 is a part of conjugate pair. So, what is the conjugate of 7? 10 minus 7 is 3. Alright, so write 3 here and immediately strike out the last 3 digits. Okay, now look at the number that is left. 79. So, what is the number that has its cube near 79? It is 4, isn't it? Because 5 cube is 125, it is more than 79. So, the nearest cube, that is the cube of a number that is either equal to 79 or it is less than that would be 4. So, the answer is 43. As simple as that. So, now let's try to find the cube root of this number. Alright, so just look at the last digit. It is 4. And you know that 4 is not part of any conjugate pair. So, copy 4 as it is and strike out the last 3 digits. Alright, now look at the number that is left, 157. So, all you need to do is find the number whose cube is either 157 or less than that. So, which would that number be? 5, isn't it? 5 cube is 125. So, write 5 here. That is what your answer is, 54. Isn't that simple? You can use this trick on your friend. You ask him to think of any number between 1 to 100 and then find the cube of it. You can allow him to use a calculator. Alright, so he'll get a huge number. Now just ask him to show you that number. And you'll just have a glance at that number and you'll be able to say what was the number he cubed. And he'll be impressed beyond his wits. Won't he be? Just try it out and let me know the results. Alright? But before you do that, you please memorize the cubes of all the numbers from 1 to 10. And now you have a good reason to do so. Isn't it? If you know the cubes of the numbers from 1 to 10, you can very easily find out the cube roots of any number whose value lies between 1 to 100. And if you know the cubes of numbers from 1 to 20, you can take that to 1 to 200. So on and so forth. If you know till 30, then it will go from 1 to 300. But for all practical purposes, knowing the cubes of numbers from 1 to 10 is good enough. Let's practice more examples. Now, you try to impress me with your ability to calculate fast. Find the cube root of this number. Alright? So, have you found it out? Okay, so let's see. So, the last digit here is 8 and the conjugate of 8 is 2. So, write 2 here and strike out the last 3 digits. Now, you are left with 373. So, what is the number that has its cube near 373? 7, isn't it? So, I write 7 here. The answer is 72. How fast can you find 13 cube? I'm giving you 8 seconds for that. Your time starts now. Your time is up. The correct answer is 2197. Now, let me show you the faster way of finding the cubes of numbers. Now, as you know that 13 cube is nothing but 13 times 13 times 13, isn't it? And how do you find that? Watch me. This is my answer, 2197. So could you understand the faster way of cubing the numbers? Okay, so let me explain it. All you need to do to cube numbers from 1 to 19 is to take the units digit as b, all right, and the tens digit as 1. It is already 1, so no big deal. I just put it as 1 here, all right. Now put these numbers in this pattern, that is 1, b, b square and b cube. Now for these two terms in the middle, just put the double of that. So for b, put twice of that, 2b. For b square, again just double those numbers, so 2b square, all right. Then just add the numbers, all right. That is what I have done here. So 1b is nothing but the number that you are given. So I have just copied 1, 3, and then square of 3, that is 9, and then cube of 3, that is 27, because there is only one place here, so I carry forward 2 to the left and write 7 here. All right, now just find the double of this number, that is b. So 2b would be 6 and double of 9 would be 18. Again I carry forward 1 here and write 8 here. Now all you need to do is add the numbers, which is not a very difficult thing to do. This would be 7, 9 plus 2 is 11, and 11 plus 8 is 19. Carry forward 1, this will become 13 plus 1 is 14, and 14 plus 6 is 20, and 20 plus 1 is 21. So the answer is 2197. 2197. So let's check out more examples. Okay, so let's find out what is 12 cube. So again we'll do the same thing. Mark the digit at the units place as B, and this is 1, so it is 1 only. Now write the numbers in this pattern. 1, 2, 2 square is 4, and 2 cube is 8. All right, now just double up these two numbers. So double of 2 is 4, and double of 4 is, right, 8. Now add the numbers. 8, 8 plus 4 is 12, and carry forward 1. So 12 plus 1 is 13, and 13 plus 4 is 17. So your answer is 1728. Let's do it one more time. Now you find out what is 11 cube. Okay, so the units digit is b, and this is 1. So write it like that. It would be, for 11 everything would be same, because 1 square is 1, 1 cube is 1, 1 times 1 is 1. So 1 and 1, and 1 square is 1, and 1 cube is 1. Okay, now double up these two digits. So double of 1 is 2, double of 1 is 2. Add them together, it will be 1331. So the answer is 1331. That's it. Okay, so tell me, what is 14 cube? All right, so mark this 4 as b, and this is 1. So again put the numbers in this pattern. So it will be 1, 4, and double of 4 is 8, and 4 square is 16. So 1, 6, and double of 16 is 32. So 3, 2, and 4 cube is 64. Now just add the digits, that's it. This will be 4, 6 plus 6 is 12, 12 plus 2 is 14. Carry forward 1 here, so it will be 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 4 is 6, 6 plus 8 is 14, 14 plus 3 is 17, and 2. So the answer is 2744. That is what 14 cube is. I hope that you know the cubes of all the 10 digits, isn't it? If you don't know, then I suggest that you please memorize them, because they are the very basic tools of every mathematician. You can always find them. Like if I say, what is 2 cubed? So 2 2 times is 4, and 4 2 times is 8. 3 cubed is 3, 3 times is 9, and 9 3 times is 27. But then that would be like wasting time. All right, so just put them to your memory. And moreover, if you know what are the cubes for all the 10 digits, then you can easily find the cube of any number from 1 to 100. And moreover, you can find cube roots of huge numbers very easily in few seconds, and that too mentally. All right, I'll be teaching you all those tricks. So just try to put these cubes in your memory. So let me just try to help you with that. So first digit is 0, so 0 cube is 0. So that is not a difficult thing to remember at all. 1 cube, again, 1 times 1 times 1 is 1 only. 2 cube is 2 times is 4, 4 times is 8. 3 cube is 27. 4 cube is 4 fours are 16 and 16 fours are 64. 5 cube is 125. 6 cube is 216. 7 cube is 343. 8 cube is 512. And 9 cube is 729. You can memorize all that in hardly 5 minutes. Alright? Okay, 10 minutes. Take it from my side. But then please do memorize them. Alright? Now. Okay, so find out what is 16 cube. Again, the same thing. 1, 6 and double of 6 is 12. And 6 square is 36. So, you write 3 here and 6 here. And double of 36 is 72. And 6 cube is 216. This is 6 cube. So, write 2, 1 and 6 here. Now, add all these numbers. So, 6. This is 6 plus 1 is 7. 7 plus 2 is 9. And this would be 7 plus 2 is 9, 9 plus 6 is 15, 15 plus 3 is 18, 18 plus 2 is 20 and 2 comes here. So, 2 plus 1 is 3 and 3 plus 1 is 4. So, the answer is 4096. That is what 16 cube is. So, now let us learn the easy cal trick of cubing any numbers from 1 to 100. So, let's take the example of 32. What is 32 cube? The easy cal trick for cubing any numbers from 1 to 100 would be that you take this digit as A and this digit as B. Last time also we did the same thing. We took this digit, the unit's digit as B, and this digit it was 1, so we took as 1, but this time it is not 1, so we are taking it as A. Alright, now see the pattern in which we are going to put the digits. So it would be A cube, A square B, A B square and B cube. In the next line, we are going to double up these two numbers. So 2 times A square B and 2 times A B square. Then we simply add the numbers. Alright, so this is the pattern that we are going to follow. So, now let's try to cube 32 using this pattern. So, A cube would be 3 cube, that is 27. Now, A square B. So, 3 square is 9 and 9 2 times is 18. Okay, so double of 18 is 36. Alright, now A B square. So, B square is 4 and 4 3 times is 12. So we write 12 here and double of 12 is 24. Now B cube. So 2 cube is 8. Now just simply add the numbers. It would be 8. 4 plus 2 is 6. 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 plus 6 is 15. 15 plus 2 is 17. Carry forward 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 plus 27 is 29. And 29 plus 3 is 32. So this is what the answer is. 32768. Okay, so let's take another example and try to find its cube. So what is 53 cube? So A cube is 5 cube, that is 125. Now A square B, that is 5 square is 25, 25 3 is 75. So write 75 here and double of 75 is 150. Using the doubling trick of faster calculation. Now, AB square. So, B square is 9 and 9 5 times is 45. So, write 4 here, 5 here and double of 45 is 90. Again, using the doubling trick. And B cube is 3 cube, that is 27. Now, just add these digits together to get the answer. 7, 5 plus 2 is again 7 and 7 plus 1 is 8, 8 plus 5 is 13, 13 plus 5 is 18. So 1 comes here, 1 plus 12 is 13, 13 plus 1 is 14. So this is the answer. If you remember, while we were trying to cube the numbers from 11 to 19, we had this thing as 1, the A as 1 and B was B only, isn't it? And that is why wherever you are seeing A, it was 1 there. So A cube was 1. A square B was B. Isn't it? 1 square is 1 only. AB square was B square only, B cube was B cube only, and the next thing it was again the double of this. So now do you see the relationship between the two patterns? This is the general pattern, isn't it? With this you can find any number, the cube of any number from 1 to 100. And with this pattern you can find the cube of numbers from 11 to 19. So let's find 72 cube. So 7 cube is 343 here. You should memorize these. Alright? Okay. Now 7 square is 49 and 49 2 times is 98. So write 9 here, 8 here. And double of 98 is, using the doubling technique, it is 196. Okay? Now 2 square is 4 and 4 7 times is 28. So write 2 here and 8 here. And double of 28 is 56. Again, doubling technique. Alright? And 2 cube is 8. So put 8 here. Now just add these digits. It would be 8. 8 plus 6 is 14. And carry forward 1. This would be 3, 11, 17, and 22. Carry forward 2 here. This would be 11. 11 plus 3 is 14. 14 plus 9 is 23. So write 3 here and carry forward 2. So 34 plus 2 is 36, and 36 plus 1 is 37. So this is what your answer is, the value of 72 cube.